Good morning, students. Welcome to chemistry class. Today I am going to be discussing about from the chapter 7 p-block elements, uses of aqueous group elements, that is noble gases. So here in the previous video discussing about chemical properties of noble gases and some structure of noble gas compounds, and here we have to know the uses of noble gases. Okay, so first one is helium. So helium is a non-inflammable and lightest gas. Helium is a lightest gas. Hence, it is used in so many purposes. The first one is in filling balloons for meteorological observation. Okay, meteorological observations, and second one is in gas cooled nuclear reactions, and another one thing is gas cooled nuclear reactions as important for this. And another one is liquid helium, the boiling point is 4.2 Kelvin. Fines used as a cryogenic agents for carrying out various experiments at low temperature. Cryogenic agents for carrying out various experiments at low temperature. So cryogenic agents used as cryogenic agents, that is used as a here helium, liquid helium used as a for cryogenic agents for the carrying out various experiments at low temperature. Okay, so while conducting the experiments at low temperature, we have to use it as a cryogenic agent, this helium, liquid helium. Okay, that is boiling point has 4.2 Kelvin. And another one is helium is used for the to produce and sustain powerful superconducting magnets. Okay, so which forms essential part of modern NMR for the spectrometer, for spectroscopy, and MRI scan. Okay, so in the systems we have to use the MRI scanning, that is used for the systems we have to use for the clinical diagnosis. So we have to use clinical diagnosis. So which type of disease is there? So by using NMR and the MRI scans, so we have to finding the some diseases. Okay, so clinical diagnosis. Okay, then another one is it is used as a diluent for oxygen in modern diving operators, because it is very low solubility in blood. So diving purpose in the sea, or whatever it may be, in that to observing the or it is used as a diluent for the diluent for oxygen in modern diving apparatus because of it very low solubility in blood, very low solubility in blood. So why? Because this is not reacted with blood, so that's why very low solubility. So for modern diving apparatus, we have to for the gas cylinders, oxygen gas cylinders. Okay, and another one is these are helium fuses, and another one is NEA. So it is used in discharge to fluorescent bulbs for advertisement purpose. Advertisement display purpose. Discharge to and fluorescent bulbs for advertisement display purpose. Okay, NEA, generally. And neon bulbs used in botanical gardens and in greenhouses. Neon used in botanical gardens and greenhouse. Okay, so these are the some of the neon used. And another one is argon. So argon is used to provide an inner atmosphere metallurgical process inner atmosphere for metallurgical process. Then another one thing is it is used for filling electrical bulbs. In electrical bulbs, so that is present argon. And another one thing is it is used in the laboratory purpose. For handling substances that are air sensitive. So these are some argon uses. And another one is xenon and krypton. Both are used in bulbs designed for the special purposes. Xenon and krypton used in electrical bulbs for a special purpose. Okay, so these are some importance or uses of the noble gases. So in the Biblock elements, all the Biblock elements 15th group, 16th group, 17th group, and 18th group. Okay, 15th group, 16th group, 17th group, and 18th group. So all are important groups. This is one of the biggest chapter in the second PUC chemistry. Okay, all are, you must be used or read perfectly, and however you try to practice all the reactions and manufactures. In this chapter very important, you know already Ostwald process, Heber process, and another one is contact process. So these are very important. These are very important. HMO3 Haber process for NH3 ammonia and this is for H2SO4. So these out of these three, one is compulsory for 3 months. One is compulsory for 3 months. Okay. So you first all the members of all the students must be learn this manufacturing of osteol, manufacturing of nitric acid by using osteol process and manufacturing of ammonia by using Haber process, manufacturing of sulfuric acid by using contact process. Okay, you must complete that practice and without seeing you may write wherever it may be. So it is asking frequently in your second PUC examination. Okay, no? So that's why you must be complete. Along with this, you must be read all the physical properties and chemical properties of the 15th, 16th, 17th, and 18th group. And it may be asking some structures, also actions of phosphorus, and some structure of 18th group elements, fluorides, xenon fluorides, and xenon oxygen compounds like this, and nitrous for oxoacids of nitrogen. So some of these you must be practice that structures also. Okay, so this lesson now it is finishing this lesson and we are going to the next chapter in the next video. Okay, thank you for watching this video.